Good evening and welcome to our program, Neighborhood Housing Services, We Believe. We are very excited to be here tonight, bringing you a lot of information that we are hoping will be beneficial for everyone. Tonight, we have a very special guest. Her name is Barbara Ochoa. Barbara is one of the housing counselors at our agency. So, Barbara, welcome.
Thank you.
Barbara, if you could please tell us about yourself and what you do at NHS.
Sure. I'm a housing counselor at NHS. I've been with NHS since December of 2018, and I have a little bit of background in property management. I also have some background in banking. So what I like to tell my clients is I bring all of that with me when I'm meeting with clients, just because they are either coming from renting and want to become a homeowner, and they're not sure of the process. And that's what we do. That's what I do there, is I help coach people to be able to become mortgage ready if that's their goal.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much. One of the topics that we're covering today is financial literacy. So, Barbara, what is financial literacy and why do you believe financial literacy is important?
Well, financial literacy is being able to acquire a certain set of skills and knowledge that can help us be able to make the best of our resources with our personal monies, to be able to make better choices. So, the reason why it's so important to me, because I didn't grow up having that background. My parents didn't know about financial literacy, so they weren't able to teach me. So I had to learn a lot about financial, my personal finances the hard way. And that was making a lot of mistakes, which then I had to learn on my own on how to correct them. So I believe in financial literacy because it's necessary, and I think that our community can just be better if more people were aware of the different things that they can do to make their lives better.
Excellent. Thank you very much. Now, what would you say are some of the obstacles somebody will face by not understanding about what financial literacy?
Well, similar to like what I said, for me, I made a lot of mistakes that I had to make up for in the long term, and it was hard to do. So, and also it took me a long time. I think if I would have known better, I would have been able to avoid a lot of those mistakes. So, you know, and when we meet with people in the agency, a lot of their obstacles are either credit issues, you know, they're not able to buy homes if they want to. And sometimes they're not even able to rent in areas that they want to rent in. They lose out on some opportunities. Just not being aware, I think, is a huge setback for a lot of people. And you miss out on opportunities to make the best of the resources that you have.
Okay. Now, on the other side of the coin, what are some of the benefits of financial literacy?
Well, the benefits are endless, I think. I think that you're just able to have a better sense of confidence when you're going into any type of transaction as a consumer, whether you're buying a house or you're buying a car, to know where you stand before you go out there and start shopping. Like, I know that I have good credit. I know that I'm able to get a good rate on a mortgage or on a loan. To know what the benefits are out there for me and be able to ask for them instead of waiting for someone to give them to you. I think that it puts you in the driver's seat as a consumer, and I think that more people need to have that type of confidence, because there's so many, you know, different types of lenders out there that are just trying to take advantage of people who don't know, you know, what they have available to them. So I just think that it would just give everybody, especially in our community, just a sense of confidence when they're out there shopping.
Now, we're seeing that there are a lot of agencies, a lot of entities that are pushing for financial literacy. What do you think, or what is NHS's role in this financial literacy movement?
Well, I'm really thankful that I began working with NHS the time that I did, because NHS didn't really begin to work with financial literacy until just recently. And you're right, there are a lot of agencies out there that are pushing financial literacy right now. And I think it's because people are starting to realize that we need it. And we need smart buyers out there to be able to take advantage of the different opportunities to buy more. With the financial crisis, with everything that happened back in 08, I mean, I think it wouldn't have been as bad if people knew what to look for and what to say, wait a minute, this doesn't look right, and back away from it. It's something that people want. When people hear financial literacy, it really, people are drawn to it because that's what they want. I think there's a need for it. There's a demand. And, you know, people, and now it's like information is everywhere. So people want to learn more. They want to get as much information that's out there to be able to benefit from it. And NHS, I think, is doing an awesome job. I'm really excited that I'm part of it because we're teaching so much. And I mean, the basics of buying a home is financial literacy. You need to make sure that your finances are under control,
correct,
you know, before you go and buy a house, because that's just a whole different ballgame of responsibilities. So if
home
you can't,
yeah,
exactly. If you can't take care of your checking account, you know, you won't be able to handle a home.
Okay. Now, for our home viewers, one message we like to share with them. What message would you like to relay on them as far as financial literacy?
I think that the biggest impression that I like to make on our clients, I think that us at NHS want to make on our clients, is that they're able and that it's never too late to start, no matter where you are in your personal finances. It's never too late to begin to improve. Yes, you've made mistakes maybe, but there's always a way to come back from that. You just need to make a decision, and that decision is to move forward. So I think that is just, you know, learn as much as you can, take advantage of any information that's out there, take advantage of counseling, which is what we do at NHS, and, you know, just believe that, you know, you can have what you've always dreamed for.
Excellent. So. Yeah, what we're trying to accomplish is not just to push the topic of financial literacy, but
right,
to share the importance on the topic of financial literacy. I think one area or one group that we really have to work on is the youth.
Yes.
Because financial literacy is not being taught in school anymore. More kids are growing up not understanding the importance of a budget or how to manage their finances. Once they become young adults, mm-hmm, and they would like to become homeowners or move forward, they are faced with all these difficulties. Would you agree that starting at a young age is a very important move? And is that something that you think NHS has an important role as part of that community?
Yes, I absolutely believe that. I always say that there's so many things that I wish I would have known coming out of high school that I think I would have saved myself from a lot of time that I wasted and money. When I first tried to buy a house for the first time, I wasn't able to because of mistakes that I made just coming out of high school.
Okay.
And
thank you for your honesty.
Yeah, of course. I mean, I like to share that because I know I'm not the only one. And sometimes when we meet with clients, they feel like they are not able to share those kinds of things, but you have to. You know, you have to get it out there. You have to be honest and just say, okay, I made this mistake, but I want to change and I want to move forward. How do I get past it? So I think NHS is really vital because we've been around for so long. I think that our image is kind of changing, where people really see us are seeing us as more educational, and to get that information and that one-on-one counseling instead of just getting a service. You know, just a one-time service. It's like an ongoing type of thing. Like, okay, I can come to buy my house, but then I can come back and get some budget counseling. Or if something happens later on in my life, I can go there and learn a little bit more. With the youth, we've been reaching out to a lot of different organizations that also are very interested in promoting this with their youth, because that's where it starts. You know, if your parents didn't know, how were they gonna teach the kids?
Absolutely.
You know?
Absolutely. Now, at the agency, you teach an 8-week course.
Yes.
About financial literacy,
mm-hmm,
not just for home ownership, but the entire topic of financial literacy. Can you give us kind of a crash course on what you teach during those 8 weeks?
I will do my best because it's a lot of information, and that's my favorite part of my job. I love doing one-on-one counseling, But my passion really is to speak to groups of people and be able to spread the word about all the great things that we're trying to teach to people so they can improve their lives. So part of the program, we talk about investing in yourself. So that's when we talk more about your personal assets as an individual, whether it be your personality, your hobbies, what are you good at? Are you good at cooking? Are you good at making things like that, and how you can turn that into a way that you can earn more income. We also go over maximizing your earnings, so that's making the best out of the money that you're receiving right now. It could be as simple as just changing, you know, your exemptions on your W-2 so that you can get a little bit more in your paycheck if that's what you need. We also go over how to read a tax return. That's not the most popular one, but we do teach that just so that we're aware of what's going on our taxes and how to understand how they come up with all these numbers. We also go over investments, which is my favorite part of the program, because it helps people. When people walk out of that session, they're always feeling more confident. Like, wow, I know what a mutual fund is now. I know what stocks are. I know how they work. And that's awesome to me, because it goes beyond just knowing how to, you know, how to write a check. Like, people are learning about things that they probably never thought that they were even able to understand. So that's my favorite part. We also talk about credit, of course, and borrowing to grow. So making good choices when you're borrowing money, borrowing for things that are going to grow in value. And that you're able to use in the future. So, for example, like buying a home. The program is not based on home ownership, but the whole structure of it is like building a home, which is why it's called Building Your Financial House. And each segment goes over a different part of a house, whether it be the roof, the walls, the insulation. So it all represents a home. And let me see what else. We talk about a lot of things in that program.
Wow, sounds like in-depth.
It is. It's a lot of information. But people have been responding really well to it. This is our second round. We've been teaching it through the South of Penn Initiative. And people are really enjoying it and learning a lot from it.
Now, this is completely... That eight-week program is different than the eight-hour course.
Yes.
That you teach at the agency.
Yes.
Can you tell us more about the eight-hour course?
Yes. The eight-hour course, we teach two Saturdays a month, every month, all throughout the year. And we teach it on Saturdays. It is a free class, and it's the ins and outs of buying a home from start to finish. So we go over the mortgage process, how to prepare to apply for a mortgage, what things you need to get yourself ready for, be it credit, income, savings. We go over the different things that a mortgage company is looking for to be able to qualify you for a loan. We also have a lender that comes in from a bank to go over their role in the process. And it's nice to have presenters because they give their own spin on, you know, what they encounter with clients and things to do and not to do. Which I love that part, because the clients are always like shocked, like, really? Like, there's a lot that has to go into it. We also have a realtor that comes in that goes over the closing process and the documents that they sign, which is also really, really important, because we meet a lot of clients that have signed documents and they didn't really know what they were signing.
They would just sign here.
Right, yeah. Right. And then they get themselves into trouble that way, because they're trusting that realtor or they're trusting that lender. And then when they go back or they're about to close, they realize, oh no, I made a mistake. And sometimes it's too late. They've probably already invested a lot of money into the transaction that they're not able to get back. So the class is meant to educate the person so they're not making those types of mistakes.
Now, what other services do you provide at the agency?
We also provide one-on-one counseling services, like I said. We have a pre-purchase counseling and credit counseling. So the pre-purchase is really to help people prepare for when they're about to close. And the credit counseling is for a person who's just starting off, where they're just thinking about, well, they come to the class because they're just thinking about it, but then after the class, they're motivated and they're like, you know what, I want to know where I'm at. So at that point, we'll do a credit pull, see where they're at with their budget, and basically just let them know, okay, these are the things that you need to do to get ready. Give them an action plan, and we follow up with them every so often, whenever, it's different for everybody. And like I said, and we also do the workshops. So our agency also has a rehab department that helps with home repair loans. And again, we have a lending department too. I'm not sure if we talked about that, but we offer assistance, closing costs, and down payment assistance for people who want to buy.
Oh, excellent. Yeah, that will be the lending program will be another topic that we're going to bring to our home viewers. Now, let's talk about budgeting, because to me, budgeting is extremely important.
Yes.
I think that I am very lucky because my wife, she does the budget. She keeps track of all the, you know, the expenses and the income. I do have to say that budgeting is a full-time job. So when she said that she was going to take that task, I said, oh, please, by all means, go ahead, do it. Mm-hmm. I think one of the misconceptions, people always think that you need to have money in order for you to do a budget. Mm-hmm. But we can say that a budget is done through the city, the business, a person, everyone does a budget. Mm-hmm. What would you share with the home viewers as far as budgeting? What are some of the important parts of a budget?
The most important part about keeping a budget, or how we like to call it, is a savings plan or a future plan, because budgeting sometimes sounds really restrictive. It's kind of like a diet. Mm-hmm. Like when you get on a diet, you know, you can't eat what you like.
Yeah,
so when you're on a budget, you can't spend on the things you like. So having a savings plan, one of the main things is remaining consistent. And because if you don't stick to it, it's not going to work. And also just making that decision that you want to make a change, and you have to have a reason why. You have to have a goal. You have to have a vision and a reason why you're going to, you know, cut back on spending on coffee or going out to eat or packing that lunch bag instead of going out for lunch because it's easier and more convenient. So it's really having a goal behind it. That's the first thing that we really need to do when we're going to make a decision like that. You need to have a goal to aim for, because if not, you're just going to fall back into your same old habits. But savings plan is changing habits, changing your spending habits, changing the way that you view things, your needs and your wants. And we help with that. I mean, it takes work, and it's hard to do it on your own. So me and my coworker Carmen, we're kind of like the cheerleaders. So, you know, we help guide our clients to believe that they're able to reach that goal. And we stick with them and hold their hand every step of the way.
Very well. Now, NHS of Greater Berks has been in existence for 40 years. Mm-hmm. So for the last 40 years, we've been promoting home ownership. We've been promoting the importance of a budget. What do you think the next 10 years will look like as far as the the future of home ownership? Do you think that people are more excited to be homeowners? Do you think people are less excited to be homeowners? What will be your take on the next 10 years?
My take on the next 10 years, just based on what I've been seeing in the past few months, is we're going to have a lot more educated homeowners and consumers, buyers out there. I think that people are going to be taking more advantage of a lot of the programs that are available. What I hope and pray for our community is that we have more homeowners who are aware and are responsible and who just take pride in the property that they have. I think that will really change the way our neighborhoods look. And especially for the city of Reading, and I say this at almost every class, you know, we need more responsible, you know, homeowners out there who care about how the front of their house looks, because then their neighbors are going to care about how their house looks, and it'll just change a lot and for our youth as well. Like you were talking about, the youth are so important, and we need to pass that on to them so they know what to do when they get, you know, when it's their chance.
Okay, now going back to the 8-hour course. Mm-hmm. You said that's been taught on a Saturday.
Yes.
It's 8 hours.
Yes.
And you do it in what languages?
We do it both in English and Spanish at the same, not in the same room. We have them split into two different rooms. One room is being taught in English, and another room is being taught in Spanish.
Okay. Is there any cost associated with the
class? No, the class is free.
And then for our home viewers, if you are interested in participating in one of the homeownership classes, mm-hmm. Just give us a call. The number is 610-372-8433. I'm assuming you would like people to register?
Yes, we would like people to register. We have limited space, so if you call ahead, we can make sure that there's a spot for you.
Excellent. Now, again, we're not trying to push homeownership.
Right.
What we're trying to do is provide information for our home viewers, our community members, mm-hmm. to understand the importance of homeownership. Well, how do we become an effective homeowner?
Right.
So I do appreciate the time that you put in. I appreciate all the efforts and the dedication. I know that when it comes to homeownership, there's a lot of misconceptions. People think that you only need to have X right. amount of money to buy, or your credit has to be certain ways.
Mm-hmm.
But it sounds like you take the time to meet with the customer. You take the time to hold their hand and say, hey, you're not here by yourself. We want to help you along the way.
Right.
Now, when you're meeting with the customer and you're holding their hands, I'm assuming that they feel more secure.
Mm-hmm.
And also they feel they're more obligated because now you have that, they have that commitment with you.
Oh, yeah.
Do you feel that they sometimes just become homeowners because, hey, you know what, Barb is just going to keep calling me and say, hey, have you done your homework? Or do you think people are just excited to become a homeowner? I mean, after all, homeownership is part of the American dream.
Absolutely.
And that's what we work on. So I just want to see it. I just wanted to hear your take as far as what do people say, hey, do they just call you and say, hey, I did my homework, when can I see you? What's that dynamic look like?
Actually, I just met with somebody today. And she called me, I think she came into the office and she was so excited. She's like, I need to meet with you because I did the things you told me to say and I think I'm ready. So she came in today and she was actually ready. And I was so excited for her. And it's happening more and more. We're getting more people coming back and actually doing the things that we ask them to do. Now, it's not all the time. I mean, it's compared to the people that come, you know, as opposed to the people that come in, the number of people that actually do the things that you ask them to do is not that many. But the ones that do, they end up actually becoming homeowners. And that's exciting to me because they're prepared. You know, they did all the things they needed to do and they're ready. So.
Excellent. Very good. So once again, the phone number is 610-372-8433. The address is 213 North Fifth Street. We're right across from Abilities in Motion on Fifth Street. Please give us a call. Call Barbara Ochoa if you have any questions as far as the services that we provide, the counseling, the workshops. Give us a call if you have questions about lending. As a nonprofit, again, our mission is to promote affordable housing and provide a lot of education. So we're here to serve the community. We are here to promote a good part, which is making the neighborhood look much better.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the ways we could do this through home ownership. So thank you very much for coming to our program. And to our home viewers, hopefully you stay tuned for our next program. And just remember that believing is just the beginning. And hopefully we have more and more to come. So thank you very much. Have a great night. And thank you for everything.